Mr. Chisholm, Clive Chisholm, and I owned the tavern. My wife Ann and I bought it right before the Civil War started. And we lived here with our youngest daughter Lillian, and we were raising four grandchildren. And Margaret, her husband John, came to stay at the tavern. And I'll let Margaret tell a little bit about why she came here and where she was from.
First of all, I want to move this whole thing. I'd like to get closer to you, Mr. Chisholm.
I'll come over there.
Well, we have a plantation in Charles City County, and the Yankees had come and they were fighting there, and they were killing all the menfolk on the plantation, so we fled to the tavern. Let's see, that was in March, I believe. We came and you started charging me rent. I understand that, though you still charge me too much.
Well, Margaret, you know, things got very, very expensive, and I kept having to raise the rent. I hated to do it, but we couldn't make ends meet.
Oh, yeah. It was a tough time. You know, and shortly after we came here, I remember I was sitting doing some knitting in that room right down below, and I heard some noises. You remember all this? And I'd never really seen them to a battle. I hadn't really seen the Yankees on the farm. I saw the results. They were marching towards the house, and they had killed some people, but I didn't see them. And then suddenly there was a battle, and I knew that people were getting shot, and there were bad things happening. I could hear it. That was that battle of Hanover Courthouse.
Yeah, some of it was a little bit around here, but most of it was south of us, a couple of miles on the farm down there owned by our friend Dr. Kinney.
Yeah, that was terrible. That was just awful. And they did, you know, those supply wagons, we were afraid we were going to starve. The Yankees would steal everything. I remember there were thousands and thousands of Yankees, and I died of violence, and they brought that supply wagon and had dead people in it.
I know. It was a terrible time. I mean, think about the people dying here at the tavern of diseases, smallpox and diphtheria and so forth. It was terrible.
It was a time just full of death. It was awful. And we did try and help the injured, but we sent them down to, what is his name again? They turned it into the hospital.
Oh, Dr. Kinney.
Yeah. That'd be interesting. I don't know. It just really unnerved me, all the people that were dying on the battlefield. What's happening to them? Their spirits. I wrote about that.
You know, Margaret, when you were here, you started a little business. You and John. Why don't you talk about that a little bit?
We started business because you raised my rent.
Well, I'm sorry, Margaret.
Well, I had an idea, and I told my husband, John, and I said, he worked at the depot. Remember, he was the quartermaster, and I said, give me some blank paper. And I started a business with the women folk that were living here, too. We
That's
made
right.
envelopes. We got a Confederate contract. We made 10,000 envelopes a month. We'll pay $35, which I put towards, well, I had to pay the women, but that was part of what we put towards our rent increase from you. But it was an interesting time that we were all here together. You know, I did employ some people. It gave them a little money.
It was interesting to see all the ladies down there folding and folding and folding, and then after so many, John would get them all and take them down to Richmond and get y'all some money.
John got all the credit, but
well, yes.
Maybe that'll change in time, that women can have businesses, but anyhow, that was good. That kept us busy, because I remember, you know, I wrote about that in the later years of my life, too, after the war. I never forgot a thing about it, the bad feelings, and I wrote about the misery, and it was just so hard, and we were poor and we were starving. But that gave us a little something to do, that company.
Mr. Chisholm?
Yes?
You guys should stay on that topic. We just got to put stuff out here.
On our business?
Yeah.
The business? Okay. So I remember John would bring paper in bulk here.
He did. So, and you know what was good about that? My son John also worked there, and he was an assistant to his daddy, and actually they then had jobs, and no one had jobs after the war. And they had jobs after the war, working at that down at the depot, still watching over the supplies. I think it was so hard, though, you know, and everyone, of course, was so surprised that I got a contract with the Confederacy, but I couldn't tell anyone because it would embarrass John that his wife went to the Confederacy and got a contract.
That she had to be working.
That's right. And that, again, we were able to share some goodness out of that. It was just difficult during that time. And I'm glad we learned that lesson. We were able to make our rent, but then we had to leave here, too.
Yeah. You know, Margaret, I started to tell you a story a little while ago.
Yeah, what was that story?
Well, In 1862, Jeb Stuart and his cavalry came by, and eventually they rode all the way around McClellan's army.
Right, right.
But they stopped here, and they actually exchanged gunfire with the Union cavalry. But what really...
When was that?
That was in May of 1862. Yeah.
Are we talking about around the battle?
Before the Battle of Hanover.
Because I did not write one thing about that.
I know. That's why I thought you weren't here at that time. But anyway, they came in the tavern and they threatened to hang me.
What?
You know why? Because of my Union sympathies. Oh, yeah, man. Yeah. I was a staunch Unionist, if you'll remember.
Yeah, I do. And I remember when the Union was here for some occupancy time.
Mm-hmm. I treated them as good as I could. But those boys were not happy with me and they threatened to hang me. It was a good thing they were on a mission.
I must have been
acclimating
to the place because I did not... Right about that, but you know, I didn't start that diary actually until 1863, and I went back and wrote from my memories what happened in 1862.
Uh-huh. But you know, in the spring of 61, actually in March, I was sitting on the front porch of the tavern, and I was watching across the street on the courthouse green. There were friends and neighbors of mine, they were giving speeches, and they wanted Virginia to secede from the Union, and they raised a secession flag, and I told them, they wanted me to come and have something to do with it, and I told them I would have nothing to do with that. And that war was caused by overzealous Southern politicians.
Well, I'm not going to comment on you because I, of course, believed in General Lee, and I believed in what he was fighting for because all I saw were the Yankees killing people, and then I saw them killing people here, and that's how I knew